Hello everyone, welcome to MESS e-learning channel. In today's tutorial we will do a practice example on boss extrude. So let us first see the so this is the 2D drawing which we are having. It's basically a bracket. Now what we'll try to do is we'll try to make this entire bracket using extrude command. We will be also using extrude cut, and we'll be making use of a symmetry command. Okay. So, like I will explain in the example itself how to make use of symmetry feature. Okay, so since we need to create a component, you go to new part modeling workbench, click on OK. So, now here in this diagram which you see, so now here the plane selection becomes very important. Now, if you look here, it is basically this is your front view, this is acting as your top view, and this is basically a left hand side view. So, we are following third angle projection method, hence on all the practice examples which we will be doing will be in third angle projection. So, if this is my front view, so if I need to make such a profile, I have to select the front plane. Okay. And if I need to make any profile which I see in the top view, I have to select the top plane. So now let us begin with the top plane. So what I will do is we will make the fillets later on. We will first create a rectangle. So the rectangle having a total length of 114 and having a depth of 11. Okay. So now let us go to SolidWorks. So we have to select top plane. Go to sketch, click on the sketch icon. Now we will make use of a centered rectangle. So centered rectangle, and we will dimension it. This will be 114. So 114 is the length. So what is the width? The width of this rectangle is, if you look in the side, it is given as 50. So this will be 50. Okay, so we have made the rectangle, click on OK, exit from sketcher workbench and go for extrude. So the extrude depth is given to us to be 11 mm, which you can see in the side view. Okay, click on OK. So now we have made this base. Now we have to go for the fillets. So always, as I mentioned during the sketcher tutorials, we no need to make the fillets in the sketch. We can directly make use of a 3D fillet option which is present. So right now we need to make two fillets of radius 14. So here you find the fillet icon, click on fillet. So the radius of the fillet is 14. Select this edge. Let us activate the full preview so that you can see how actually the fillet will be looking like. So this is one of the edge which is having a fillet of 14. This is the second edge which is having a fillet of 14, and then you click on OK. Okay. So if you look from the top view, we have finished with the base. Okay. Now let us go for this portion. If you see, it's basically a cylindrical block. Actually, the inner hole which you see here of diameter 12, it's a through hole. So it's like we have not shown hidden lines over here, but this hole of diameter 12 is a through hole. So we are having outer circle of diameter 16 mm. Okay. So let us try to make this 3D profile with the help of selection by contours. So let us begin. So here my sketching plane will be this face. So I'll select this face, go to sketch, click on the sketch icon, press Ctrl A to make the screen parallel towards you. So you create two concentric circles. Okay. So I have just created two concentric circles. So we have seen the inner circle is having a diameter of 12 and the outer circle is having a diameter of 16. Now we have to locate the center point of these two circles. So let us see the sketch. So here if you look in the diagram, the vertical distance is 25 and 19. Okay, so let us dimension it. So this is going to be 25 and this distance is given as 19. Okay, so this is done. Exit. So first thing is we will extrude the outer circle. So it's having a height of 14. So go to features, extrude. Okay, so this one will be 14. Now inner circle, that is of 12, as I mentioned, it's going to be a through hole. So we have to remove it. So let us go for extrude cut, expand this part 2 in. Again you expand the boss extrude 2, which we basically use to make the cylinder, and select the sketch. Okay, so activate the selection by contours, just right click in this region and clear the selection. We need this inner circle, okay, which will be basically acting as a revolves extrude cut profile. Okay, so we have to basically go for both the direction. Direction 1 is coming in the downward side and we have to go for direction 2. So make sure like it is crossing the 3D model, like the outer cylinder which we just made. Okay, it should just come outside so that we can have a through hole. Click on OK. Okay, so now this is done. Now let us go back to the drawing. So here we are having a fillet of 3 mm. So how to give a fillet? Click on the fillet icon, make this to 3 and select this edge. Okay, so now if you look in the top view, so we are finished with this region. Now let us focus on this side. Okay, so let us make this profile first. We will be concentrating on these two concentric semicircles which you see here of diameter 72 and 46. Okay, so in order to make those, so this face will act as my sketching plane because I am looking at that drawing from the front view. So select this face, click on edit sketch, control 8. Outer circle is 72. So actually what we are assuming is the center point distance from here till here, it's basically half of the outer circle, that is it's the radial distance which we have here. Okay, so now make a circle of 72, select this point, press control, select this, coincide, select this circle, press control, select here and tangent. Okay. So let us just make the outer circle. So we will just extrude this semicircle up to this surface. So exit, go to extrude. I will flip the direction of extrude and this will be up to next. Up to next won't come here, so let us go for up to surface and select this surface. Okay, now let us make the inner semicircle, which is basically a slot, semicircular slot of diameter 46. Again I have to select this face, edit sketch. Now we have to make a circle of diameter 46. Now see, I need the same center point as we had made for the first semicircle. So how to locate the same center point. First, initially you just scroll the cursor on this circle, a semicircle which we had made earlier. The moment you scroll, you will find this symbol over here. So, this symbol basically represents the center point of the semicircle, of this semicircle. Okay. So, just bring your cursor down, left click on the mouse button. So, this will act as the center point, and then now dimension the semicircle. This will be having a diameter of 46. Okay. So, now this will go for extrude cut, it will be up to next, click on OK. Okay, so here we are done. Now, if you look at the drawing, we don't have a step here. So, we have to remove that step. Again select this, click on sketch. So, what I will do, I will just make use of this 3-point arc. We will first make a, sorry, not 3-point arc, we will make use of center point arc. We'll make an arc which starts from here and ends here. Okay. And then let us just close this arc. Okay, so let us give dimension to this. So, this is say 72. Now, this length doesn't matter because we are just creating it with the intention of removing this portion. Okay. So, once you have created it, exit, go to extrude cut up to next, okay, and click on OK. So, is it clear? Now, if you look at the drawing, we are having a fillet of radius 2. So, go to fillet, let us make it to 2 and select this edge, click on OK. Okay. So, now we are done till here, but if you look in the front view, the outer semicircle is not continuous, like there is a cut over here. Okay, so we have to basically slice the top portion. So, now we have to remove this much portion up to a depth of here. So, whatever semicircle which we have, we can see the complete semicircle in this region, whereas on the other sides it is basically removed. Okay, so now we have to remove this much portion. So, this depth of cut will be basically how much? So, the total width is 50. If we subtract from it 28, you will get 22. So, basically we have to go for a depth of cut of 11 on both the sides. Okay. So, now let us begin with this geometry, sketching this geometry. Again I will select this, edit sketch, control 8. So, first thing is they have mentioned the height, like what is the height of this horizontal end with respect to the base. Vertical height is 30. So, let us make a horizontal line. Okay. Now, I will just go to convert entities and I will just project this curve into the existing sketch. Okay. So, you have this sketch being projected or this curve being projected. I will just remove the entities which I don't need. I don't need this portion. Okay. So, this will be my sketch profile which you see here, and now let us go to extrude cut. After completing the sketch, extrude cut, the depth of extrude cut will be 11. Okay. Now, same profile has to be removed on the other side. So, instead of making the sketch again and then going for extrude cut, we can now go for symmetric. Okay, so symmetric option you can find here. Just click on this drop down arrow or linear pattern. Symmetry here basically it means mirror. It's a 3D mirror which we are going to do. So click on mirror option. So first thing is, which is the feature you need to mirror, okay. So the feature to mirror is this, and the mirror face or plane. So just expand this. So what you can see, the front plane is basically present exactly at the center of this complete 3D model. It is coming so because when we made the first extrude of a rectangle, we had made it using centered rectangle with the center point of the rectangle as the origin. That is why we do not have to create a separate plane for going for mirror option. Now, once the plane is selected, click on OK. Okay. So, we have completed this portion, both the sections has been removed. Now, let us go for this. Now, we have to create this profile. Now, where you will create this profile? That is a question which comes in front of you. Will you create on the front plane or will you create on the right plane? So, basically I will select the front plane. I will create this profile and then I will basically make use of a mid plane extrude. Okay, so let us just create this profile. Select front plane, click on sketch. So, let us first make these two concentric circles. So, both are having diameters 28 and 38. Outer circle is having 38, inner one is having 28. Total distance from the center point till here is 72. Okay. Let us make a reference vertical center line. Now, this both the circles will be concentric with respect to this line. So, not concentric, already circles are concentric. It will be, this outer circle will be tangent with respect to the vertical reference line. So, select this circle, press control, select the vertical line and go for tangent. Click on OK. Okay, so this is done. Now, we actually require this profile, that is the outer curve. So, I will go to convert entities, select this, so not the face, just this outer edge, then this edge. Okay. Now, see, look at the selection. I have selected these two 3D edges and see when I click on OK, see where it comes. So, both are projected on the sketching plane. This is the use of convert entities. They are basically used for projecting 3D edges. Okay. Once we have made this, again just make it parallel to the screen. Okay. So, now let us trim it. Okay, so if you look, this is the final profile and now we will go for mid plane extrude. From both the sides, the total depth will be 28, which you can see here. Okay, so now this is complete. Now let us see what is remaining in this drawing. So if you see here, we are having a slot over here, a rectangular slot. So now to make that, I have to select this plane, that is the right plane. So instead of selecting the right plane, we can select this face and go to edit sketch. Okay, so let me make a vertical reference line. Let this be vertical. Okay, so it is not coincident with the origin. Let me just make it coincident. And let us make one more reference line over here. Okay, now let's go for the center rectangle. So what you can see, it is 12 by 12. Okay, so this dimension is 12 and distance from this to this face, it is 12. Okay, so it's not fully defined. Let us just fully define. What matters is the lower distance. This is what matters. This is bottom part should be 12 and the width should be 12. Once this is done, exit, go for extrude cut, and here we'll go for up to next. Click on OK. Okay, so the 3D model is complete. So now the way of creating this 3D model may differ from person to person, but we have just made the complete 3D model using basic steps. So I hope so you are clear with how to make use of extrude boss feature, extrude cut feature and mirror feature, which we just see in this example. So in the next tutorial, we will be understanding revolve feature with the help of an example. Thank you.